Hello viewers, in this video we will discuss about how to remove bad data points and how to move data points. Okay, before going to that, just we will draw the graph. So here I am taking some cold type plots. Okay, in that I will explain how to move and how to remove bad data points. Before going to that, see here, for drawing cold plots, so we have to take z dash and z double dash here. Okay, and I am drawing multiple curves here. For that I am taking multiple x and multiple y's. Okay, this is x axis and z axis, z dash and z double dash is y axis here. Okay, similarly I am changing here, this also x. Okay, and next here also x. Similarly, okay, for that just we have to double click for changing the axis of these. Okay, just double click on here. Okay, and dialog box will open. In the dialog box we have to change which axis we want. Here we want x axis, na just select and apply. Otherwise if you change one by one column means automatically it will be applies here. Okay, see, so just I double clicked and I selected x axis and then after I click on here. Okay, automatically here x axis will be selected like that. Okay, finally we can apply. If you apply it, see here also x axis will come. Okay, now okay, click on okay. Okay, now just draw the directly, we can select all and just click on here. Okay, so see here, the data shown out of frame, so that's why we have to rescale it. For that just click on here. Okay, it came like this. So cold plots will be actually in this manner. Okay, so here so many bad data points are there, so these all are bad data points. Okay, that means unwanted points, so we can remove them. Otherwise we can move them. Okay, there are two options are there. Okay, so that means for that what we will do, first we will discuss. See here, so we will select one by one. If you will select all means we will confuse. Okay, then after we will select all. Okay, so just I am deleting this. I will draw again. Yeah, first I will draw this. Okay, if you click on here, see, so it's came like this. Okay, so here we have to change the scale. This is cold type plots, that's why we have to change the scale. How to change the scale means, see here, so come to here, see, so this is okay. Yeah, so in x axis it will be in m. So okay, and y axis left side it will be like 10 to the power of 7, that is like that. So that's why we can make like engineering. If you click engineering means automatically it will come, apply, see, so it's came. So and one more is decimal places. We no need here, there is no decimals, so that's why decimal places are not required. So that's why click on set decimal places and click on 0. If you want one decimal means click on place here 1. 2 decimal points means suppose I will put the 2, 2 means what happened here? Apply. Yeah, see here, 2 decimal points came. Okay, now I will keep just 0. See, apply. Okay, there is no decimal points. And now coming to the x-axis. See here, also one extra decimal is there. We are not required decimal. Okay, I'm just keeping 0. Apply. Okay, now coming to the so we have to make scalar equal. Here 140 is there, here 120 is there. So we have to match scale. So because why we are doing like that means, before drawing the cold plots, here I am drawing cold plots. That's why before drawing the cold plots, scale should be equal. Okay, we will take what is the highest scale here, that only we will take. Okay, because otherwise we will miss some data points if we will take least scale. Here 150 m is it. Okay, so that's why I am taking here also 150 m. Apply here. Okay, now so we have to cold plot should start at 0. Okay, so that's why, so here I will kept 0, and here also I will kept 0. Okay, sometimes in bad data points will be there, we have to move that bad data points. That's why we will take negative scale also, depends on the our graph. Okay, after moving the data points, so we'll set the scale is 0. Okay, just click on apply. Now okay, this is the actually cold plot. Cold plot means it will come, select here this. So if you fit this curve, actual trend after this curve will be like this. Actual trend of the this curve will be like this. Okay, so that mean okay, click on okay. That means if you want to increase the this size, means we can select all whatever data we want. Okay, now actual trend is like this. Okay, because of some experimental errors and some instrumental errors, so it may come like this. Okay, by using some softwares like JetView, okay, so we can fit this curve. Software is not free, so that's why, so some people are not having their softwares, so that's why for them, so I am explaining how to fit this. Okay, see here, just go to data, so just move data points. So just click on yes. Okay, now see, so this is the actual trend. Okay, like this. Okay, just click on here. This is the some trend. Okay, this is the trend of the actual trend of the cold plot. Now we will check the how to remove bad data points. Now similarly we will check the this example here. So just select the x and y axis here, just click on here plot. Okay, select data range. Okay, so this is too far, that means this is entire purely bad data point, so that's why we have to remove this bad data point. For that, just click on data and remove bad data points. Okay, now just double click on it. Now it's removed. Okay, just simple. What we have to do, just click on data, just click on remove bad data points, then after just double click on whatever we want to remove the data point. Okay, so this is the method to do the remove the bad data points. Now we will move the both graphs combinedly. Now we will observe how we will move data points here. See, now click on the scale here. Yeah, see here. So this graphs will be like this. So we have to set the scale here again. Okay, scale will be like this. So 0 and wait first before we will convert, both are in same. So engineering K, so whatever we will put, we will put 10 to the power of 8 also, that means decimal also, both are in same. Okay, now coming to the bottom. Yeah, this is engineering only, and set this is 0. Okay, yeah. So, and these all are overlapped here. See, some values are overlapped, so that's why I will take scale is here, that is increment here, I will take 50. Now I have to adjust the scale here. So in x-axis maximum is 190 is a, in y-axis 140 is a, so both the we have to kept equal. Okay, here also 0, just click on apply. Now these are the shape of the coal blocks. Okay, now here see, we'll check here. So here there is a some bending is a, for that just maximize it. Okay, so now we have to move these points, means here whatever we want to change, which graph we want to change, first select that graph. Okay, first graph is black and second graph is red. Okay, yeah, first graph is black. Suppose if you want to move red point, means click on the red. Okay, now graph is selected, again click on the data, and now move data points. Yeah, see here some error, some will be there, so that I am moving, that is the experimental error only. Yeah, now click on here. Okay, now again go to the data, so click on the graph one, and again click on the data. So now click on move data points. Yeah, see here, now it will move because we are selecting here second one. Okay, like that we can move the, so now click on the pointer. Yeah, so now it will come. Okay, so why I kept the spike here, means this is the interaction between the electrode and electrolyte material, so that this is the way to move back data points without changing the x-axis. We can draw the, we can move the back data points. In the previous graphs I explained regarding about the coal plots, but here I am explaining one more. So just draw between the frequency versus capacitance. I am drawing here. Okay, just keep put in auto and apply. Okay, so now okay. Yeah, so if maximal is there, means these values doesn't change, these values doesn't change. Okay, now make it, this is the x-axis. Now make it, this is the x-axis. Now just apply it. Now click on OK. Now draw the graph here. Okay, rescale it. Okay, now we want to draw between, in between. Yeah, so we want to draw the graph between frequency and capacitance. So that's why select these two. Okay, now draw. So rescale it. Yeah, so now we have to move bad data points here. So maximize it. Yeah, again maximize it. So that means here nothing will be, maximum changes are not there. In some cases some changes will be there. So at that situation it will be work. Okay, see here. Yeah, what we will do, just click on the data, move data points. See here, if I will move the data points like this, yeah, so x axis doesn't change. 250, actually this is 2500, we are added 1, so that's why 2501. Okay, so that is does not change. See here, if you move also, only y axis is changing, x axis does not move. Okay, yeah, see here, bring it, yeah, so like this. Okay, so if you move data points like this also, okay, okay, so like that, if you move any bad data point, see here also, click on data, move data points, yeah, see, you can move. So whatever the trend we want, we can move like that. Okay, yeah, this is the trend now actually. Okay, so increasing and up to increase a certain point and again decreases. Okay, that is the trend here. So okay, that is the trend here. So like that we will draw the, okay, see, so now this is not required right now, so now make it versus C. Now we will get the actual graph. Yeah, this is the actual graph right now. Okay, so here there is, okay, so that's why with the points click on yes. If you move it, so see here, yeah, if you are moving means x is changes, y also changes, but x is the frequency that should be constant, that should be constant. Okay, so that's why we have to fix the x-axis. How to fix the x-axis, I will tell you. Okay, yeah, just go here, just we don't want any changes now, just that's why I make it control Z, undo. Okay, see here, okay, here nothing is changed. So that's why for that just add one column, insert one column here, yeah, so one column is inserted. For that set column values, see here, so I am writing one formula here. Okay, what is that formula? Just I am adding column a frequency. So just make it plus 1, okay, anything minus 1 or anything, whatever you want to do. So, and thank you. If you would like our video, please subscribe our channel.